morning.
We'll open the floor to questions.
Okay. AJ, how much do you think the experience that you guys have had here?
Experience the NCAA tournament? You know, I think it helps. The logistics and everything that go into playing in this event are very different. They're exciting and they're fun, but they're different. More formal, there's just more hoopla in a good way, and it should be. You want to get to a point where you feel like it's different. So all those things are great positives, but just having done it before, at least you can talk about what it's going to feel like, try and settle them in. Try and make sure they have a good, productive day of practice today and just get everybody comfortable. But I do believe, and I've said this before, once the game starts, all that kind of goes out the window. I think it kind of just helps you settle in and have a good couple of days beforehand. But once the game goes, and it just kind of depends on how the game goes. So.
Aaron, given that this is the highest seed you guys have ever had, you know, a lot of times in the past you've been an underdog coming into this tournament. Is the message all different, or the approach different? Does it feel different in that, at least in this first round game, you're the favorite this time?
Yeah, no, I don't think it feels any different for us. We didn't do anything different this past week. We didn't talk about the tournament or the game any differently. We didn't talk about our opponent any differently. You know, I think we've said in the past when we've been a lower seed and we've reminded our team then to, and I think it was true then, it's true now, the difference between a 6-11, is very, very small. You know, our records are the same. You know, you look at teams and how they performed in the regular season, the margin is just razor thin. You're talking about maybe one win on our side, one loss on their side, and we've been on the other side of that. We've been the lower seed, and you can look at kind of records, you can look at performance, and you can see, oh boy, things are really close, even though the seed might be a little bit different. So it'd be hard to go around and change the message now when we're in a better seed. So we kind of approach it the same way and just make sure our team understands you're playing a really good team. And they certainly have as much, you know, tournament history as we have here recently. They've had success in the tournament recently. So all the positives that we could talk about, they could talk about on their side. And that's why, again, it'll come down to how that game goes tomorrow morning.
You're playing in a much different environment in a dome. You walk in and the place is massive, and I know that your seniors have played at the Dakota Dome, but this is like a little bit bigger. How tough is that to adapt to this?
Yeah, we'll find out. You know, I haven't been out there yet. I think having a practice there today will be helpful. It'll just kind of take everybody's, you know, look around and see what it feels like out of their mind, get some shots up. I've never felt like the environment, big gym, small gym, dome, arena, changes things dramatically. I think on the floor, players seem to just kind of settle in, and all of their, you know, variables are the same. So in the past, I don't think it has. But again, we've never played here before, so it's hard for me to say for sure or not. But I just think when you get to this point in the year, you could play the game outside, and good players are going to be good players. They're going to rise to the occasion. You can play in a dome, you can play in an arena. Good players are going to find a way to get things done, and our group, I know, will be excited to try and do that.
Aaron, do you see some similarities here between the teams? I mean, two very long winning streaks, two coaching staffs that have been in place a long time, two teams that have been really good defensively, and if so, you know, how does that, so what do you expect that to impact the game?
Yeah, I think, yeah, there are a lot of similarities. You know, you can use the phrase the mid-majors. They've had a lot of success. We both have scheduled, I think, really well. And that hasn't been just a one-time thing. Both teams have had a really good trajectory for years now. Specifically to them, they defend really well. Like, I think we're a good defensive team. They're a great defensive team. And you can see that on film. You can see that in their numbers. They make it hard for people to score. So that's a big concern of ours. Some of the things that we do well, just penetration or post-ups, they defend those things really well at an elite level. They make it really hard for you to get the ball inside in any way, off of penetration, cuts, post-ups. They just do a good job of taking that away. So we're going to have to be patient, I think, a little more so offensively. You know, we don't want to slow things down. That's not what I mean. But we just can't settle. I think if you settle against them, you end up taking a lot of really tough shots. So we're going to have some patience there, I think, offensively. And that's something we can do, but it's not necessarily our nature. So we'll have to work on that. And then they rebound really well. holy cow, they rebound well. They get a ton of second chance points, and I think we're a good rebounding team, but they're a great and elite offensive rebounding team, and they just get so many second chance points. So those are the two things we've talked a lot about coming into this game, is just how we need to, you know, approach the offensive side to score against a really good defensive team, and then how we need to make sure we finish possessions defensively and try and rebound against them.
Casey Miller's dad, all-time leading scorer for a long time at Dakota Wesleyan in South Dakota history of college basketball, Alan Miller. Hagen Larson's dad, Keith Larson, was one of the most prolific high school players in the state history. Mm-hmm. And of course, Maddie's mom, Melissa, was the all-time leading scorer in Augustana as a collegiate. How does that affect their, you know, the fact they grew up in that kind of a family? Obviously, that's going to make you more want to recruit players like that, but how much better do you think that's made them?
Yeah, no, that's a good question. I just think they've all been around sports and, you know, siblings in those families too. So you talk about parents, but, you know, brothers and sisters, different sports in some cases, but their three families are just have phenomenal athletes everywhere. And so I think they understand the competitive nature, the drive that it takes. I think they understand very well the ups and downs. You know, a lot of people, you could look at a Macy, Maddie, and Tegan and think everything is always just, you know, easy and roses, and that's not the way it works in college athletics. There's good days, there's tough days. And so I think when you have people around you that have been through that, you're more prepared to handle it. You've got a good support structure around you. When you have good days, people to remind you that, hey, you're not the greatest ever. This is good. Enjoy it. And when things don't go well, hey, you know, you're going to be fine. You're going to be able to bounce back. So I just think it helps with the foundation, the approach that it takes. But all three have been phenomenal people for us. They're just great young women and obviously really good players, and just a joy to be around from our perspective.
Hi, Coach. I guess I'm curious, you know, with Syracuse.com, Lindsey Kramer spoke to you briefly on the phone. You know, people in Syracuse are very familiar with you know, the ACC basketball coming to Dome, Washington, Syracuse. And while the other three teams coming in are accomplished in their own right, maybe, you know, people around here from Quinnipiac, Fordham, South Dakota State. So could you just kind of give people a feel that are familiar with mid-majors from around the country, what the outlook is coming in, perhaps taking on an ACC team potentially in their dome, and, you know, kind of the outlook you bring into a tournament like this as a mid-major?
Well, I think I think we're always just happy as heck to be playing in this event. You know, these are hard events to get into. In our world, you don't make it if you're fifth or sixth place team in a conference, and that's a whole different world. You've got to be really good, and you've got to play well at the right times, and we've done that. The other three outside of Syracuse had to do that too. And then on top of it, I think different styles of play for sure. Not better or worse, but just very different styles of play. I think for us, you're going to see a team that really moves the ball really well. We average about 18 assists a game. College basketball is trending away from assists. We seem to be trending towards them, so that's a little bit different a style, I think. But I would also say you're going to see some really good basketball players. I think sometimes, especially in the last several years, it's continuing to improve and change. You see a team concept, but I think the perception is always that the players are just, you know, different. They're not capable of playing in the ACC or these levels. And in reality, you'll see some phenomenal young women on the court. For us, Macy Miller could certainly play in the Big Ten or Big 12, those kind of conferences in our areas. Tegan could certainly do that. Madison Giebert could certainly do that. They would have had chances out of high school to do that. So I think when you see these mid-major teams that are having a lot of success, it's not just about, you know, system or they have their niche, you know. There's some elite players on these teams, and we certainly have some of them, and that's why we've been to a lot of these tournaments. Is that what you're looking for?
Is it, like, follow up? I asked you on the phone the question about each of the three teams other than Syracuse is on immense winning streaks. And I know you kind of played that down a little bit as far as this being a reset. Could you just elaborate a little bit on that more about how the three of you come in, you know, 15, 20 game winning streaks, whatever. Right now, none of that really matters as far as momentum, what you've done here.
You know, I think the winning streak speak towards a team's ability to achieve, and that's what you have to do in this tournament. You have to find ways to win. You don't go undefeated in your conference like our opponent did without having to find a way to win some tough games. Not everything just rolled along for them. So I think you can draw confidence from that as a staff, from a player perspective. You know you can dig down when you really need to. You've had to win on the road away from your own facility to get that done. You've had to probably beat some rivals in your league, people that are really gunning for you. You had to get through a conference tournament where the pressure is great and everybody's playing their best basketball and find a way to win, and all three teams have done that. But I do believe, though, you know, when the ball goes up tomorrow, some of that stuff is out the window. I think you can draw on it and feel good, and there might be times in the game where all of us have to go back and say, hey, we've been here before. We can do this. But it still is really about trying to play well in those moments tomorrow during the game.
9 times in 11 years you've been here. That very first year had a pretty special team. How special do you think this group could be?
Well, I mean, I think they're equally special to all of our great teams. And the hard part about the NCAA tournament is, you know, you're talking about that team went on to win down in Lubbock, beat TCU, and then really lost on a fairly last-second shot to Baylor for a chance to go to the Sweet 16. So that's a special finish to that season, a special accomplishment, a special run. But that team was special even if they didn't, you know, beat TCU. This team is special regardless of what happens tomorrow for all that they've already done, and some of the individual accomplishments that we've had are phenomenal. We may not see again, really, when you start talking about greatest ever in some of those categories. But they have a chance to have a special run right now, too. And the other teams in this bracket do as well, so our chance is no different than theirs. But I do think that provides more excitement and motivation and drive. Again, our opponent, Quinnipiac, they have a bunch of seniors. And when you look at their roster, I'm sure they're sitting here thinking, this is our chance. You know, we are a group of people who have been doing this for a while. We're together. Nothing's going to stop us. We've got some really good seniors, and I'm sure feel that too. So we'll see, you know, how the game goes. But I think the teams here definitely have a chance to have a special run and really make a memory. You know, you just reflected on something that happened 11 years ago, and people in our world still think about that, talk about that, and that's what the NCAA tournament gives people a chance to try and achieve. So it'll be fun to see what we can all do.
But seldom will you have two senior leaders that are, I guess I always kind of felt watching this team like these two were not going to let the season end any sooner than it possibly could.
Yeah, no, Macy and Maddie have been great, and I think they'll put everything they can into this game tomorrow. You know, and they have a great cast around them. Tegan, you'll get to hear from here, is a tremendous player and a big part of why we're here right now, her growth and development. Sydney Palmer, another senior who may not be up here, but she's also been a captain and a leader. And at this time of the year, yeah, I think seniors really have a lot to do with how your team goes. You know, they find that extra drive, they find that extra gear, that extra, you know, motivation when they need it. Ours are really poised. That's a great quality here in these tournaments because there's a lot of pressure and things go up and down. And when you have people that can be really poised and make plays. But I would say, you know, after that time, we had some really good seniors in that group. And I think everybody said, ooh, that you might not have another senior class like that. And I think we've had a bunch of senior classes like that. And you have to be able to continue to do that to get to this level. So Macy, Maddie, Sid Palmer, phenomenal seniors. And we sure hope we have a chance to down the road have other classes like that too.